everybody on my personal page because we're going to do the top look from last week's, I think it was Friday, that my VIPs really liked. So we're going to do a neutral eye, a bold lip. We're going to even out this crazy skin tone. And shout out goes to Miss London because she watched my video on my VIP page. She stayed up late. She's 7 years old. My friend Kathy's daughter. So big shout out to you, honey. Thanks for watching. So guys, we are going to do that look again and I want to share it with you. So we're just going to start evening all this out. You gotta work with a good palette first, right? So I have my Uplift Serum on. I put this on, I let it set for a little while. And this is amazing for moisture. My skin, when I was home in Pennsylvania, started peeling. It was so dry and cracking and I didn't know what to do. So I just started putting this on. This is normally my nighttime routine trick, but I started putting it on before I put my makeup on. I just let it sit for a little while and it's been doing wonders. No peeling. I have redness, but no peeling, no anything like that. I already have my Glorious Touch primer on. I like to put that on and let it sit for maybe 5 minutes or so, just so my makeup, so it can sink into my skin, so my makeup doesn't smear. And it's amazing. It's so light and so gorgeous. So now I'm going to use my Touch Liquid Foundation. I'm going to turn this down just a little bit. I'm going to use my Touch Liquid Foundation. Now, I'm in this weird in-between right now. My skin is very splotchy and pale. So I decided to go a little bit lighter and use the Scarlet Foundation. But I'm going to mix a little bit of Organza for me right now. Nobody else I know really has this problem right now. But right now, I'm just in between shades. So I always make sure I squeeze out that goodness. There's oils in here, essential oils that our skin needs. So we need to shake it all up and get it all mixed back together because it just settles, you know, oil and water. So it settles, but you want to mix all that in so you can get all that goodness. So we're going to shake these up. And then I like to use a foundation brush. So this isn't everybody's cup of tea, but I really like to do it. So our foundation brush is right here. And I am just going to... anything at all you guys wanted to browse that I'm talking about, I'm gonna post that here. My link is below my website, and so if you just want to look at it a little bit more up close and personal, you can do that there. So we're just gonna go for it. We're gonna go in. I only use about 4 drops of this foundation, guys, so it's a lot. A little goes a long way. I'm sorry, a little goes a long way. So, and because I'm gonna use just a few different colors, 2 different colors, I'm gonna use just 3 dollops of Scarlet. And then I'm gonna use a little bit of, probably about 1 dotful of Organza, just to warm that up just a little bit. So I put a dot of the Organza on each one. That was just for me. As you can see, my neck is very pale right now. You wanna match your neck and not the redness on your face, okay? That's what you wanna match too. So I just pat it all around. I pat it all around and then I buff it in, but I wanna make sure I get it kinda everywhere at first. So I pat it around and then I buff it in circular motions. Like so. And I stay away from under my eyes because I'm going to put concealer there. And also, I'm going to put eye primer on. And so I want that, any shadow, the makeup that I want to touch that eye primer is the shadow, not my foundation. Now that's just my personal preference. If my music is too loud, please let me know. Listening to some Pink here in the background. So I'm buffing this out up into my hairline. You see how it's matching my neck? It makes me look a little pale because all that redness is gone, but that's what you want. You want that redness gone. My skin is very blotchy and red. I'm gonna use my mirror here just to make sure. Yeah, I bring it down my neck just a little bit. I want to make sure it gets into my hairline because ain't nobody want any lines here. So Absolutely, you have a mask on. Guys, this foundation is so soft and supple, and it feels like nothing on. It feels like literally nothing. And I teach group fitness classes, and I sweat like I don't even know what, and I never have to reapply it. So this is a one time a day foundation for sure. All right, guys, so that is my foundation. See, you see my neck is all evened out with my face. And then what we're going to do is we're gonna add life back into that face here shortly. But first, I'm going to use my concealer. Concealer, I always use concealer under my eyes, right here. Because under here it gets very dark, my eyes are deep set. And then right in my nose, do you see that right there? There's a shadow that I wanna kind of brighten up. You can see that, right? Okay, so I'm gonna use Scarlet Concealer. Where is my brush? There it is. Concealer brush is my favorite. I'm gonna put this on with the concealer brush, and I like to put it on my hand. My concealer, can you see that? On my hand, and then I kind of paint with it. So, and a little goes a long way, guys. This will be enough for all the contouring that I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna start highlighting under my eyes, and I'm gonna do some contouring. Super simple, I know it's a scary word. I'm no makeup artist, believe me, and I figured it out. So, I can't say I figured it out because my way might not be everybody's way. So we are going to, I just like to go in a triangle. And I love to go into the insides of my nose. Do you see how I'm brightening that up? I'm just placing this concealer where I want it. And then I'll be taking a blending bud and brush and buffing it out. So you will see. But I want to make sure I put it exactly where I want it. You want lightness and brightness to be drawn up to your eye. And that's what this is doing right now. Okay. So put that on. This brush is amazing. It's so, you see there's no breaks in the lines. Down the center of my nose, and this is where I'm going to start doing that contouring, okay? I'm going to use a little bit more concealer, literally a pen tip, okay? And I'm going to go up my forehead here. This is just adding brightness, okay? I'm going to go on my chin. If you want your lips to look a little fuller, go right here on the Cupid's bow. And when I break out, because I'm so fair, I don't know if you saw that. I had this weird breakout right there that it doesn't leave a scar, but it stays red for a really, really long time when I break out. So, curse of pale girl problems. All right, guys, so that's my basic contouring that we're gonna do. Now I'm gonna take a blending bud. Okay, you can wet it. I'm not gonna wet it today. You can go to my link. We have them on my site, but you can also get these from like Walmart, which I think is where I got this one because I was out of blending buds. So I buffed that out. What I'm doing is I'm kind of pressing it into my skin. Press, press, press. I like to press my concealer in. I don't want to swipe it around. And this was a top look from last week on my VIP page. And it was also a lip look that I had never done before. And I've worn it a zillion times since, and I love it. And it's long wear, smudge proof, kiss proof. And you're gonna see how. Super moisturizing. And we're gonna do kind of a really pretty, more of a neutral eye, because we want that lip to kind of pop. I like to do, you know, a bold eye and a subtle lip, or vice versa. That's just my personal preference. Okay, so we have that all buffed in there. Now what I'm gonna do, a little trick for you guys, is I'm going to take my pressed powder here that I have in Organza, and I am just going to take a little swipe with a fluffy brush. I have my powder concealer brush. Tap it in there, and I am just going to swipe it under my eye here. And what that does is it kind of sets that makeup that liquid makeup. Okay. And it will prevent creases and fallout on your skin and make like fallout that will stick. So, and while I'm doing mine, I'm now going to add life back to my face. But while I'm doing that, I am going to quickly put on our eye primer because I want that to set. I want that to set while I'm doing some other things. Grab the wrong one. We have two eye primers. This was the original and it's a little bit more liquid based. This one is a little more stiff and it's a little more tacky, which is amazing. Like my makeup does not move. If you are on my VIP page and you saw my 8-hour after post, my eye makeup did not move. And you'll see that I place colors in specific spots, and with the eye primer, it didn't move at all. So pretty awesome. So I just put it on my finger, use like a pen size amount, just a little pen tip size amount, just a little bit. Maybe a little bit more than that. And I put it on here. You remember I didn't put any foundation or concealer on my lids, and this is why. Because I want that concealer or that primer to really do its job. So we're gonna let that sit because it's still a little bit wet. We want it to get all nice and dry and ready to do some work for us. So now, guys, we're gonna do simple contouring. It's super duper easy. We are going to take our beachfront bronzer, okay? And we're gonna take, what brush is this? Blusher brush. Everybody I see like tells you what brushes they're using. I always forget, it's a blusher brush. So, it's a shimmer and a matte side. I use just whatever, I just use both, okay? I go right under that cheekbone, up into that hairline. And I kind of start pressing it under that cheekbone. I start pressing. Seriously, make a little that funny face so you know where you want that to be. Okay. Do you see adding life back in? I also go up onto my forehead here. What this does is all that contouring, remember we did with the concealer? It's gonna brighten that up. So where the sun would naturally hit you or the light, it's gonna be really bright. See, getting life back. You gotta start with a clean palette. That's what we do with the foundation. Very even. And that's a great place to start. I bring it under my chin here. Chisel out that jaw, right? And look how simple this is. Guys, I put it in three places. Under my cheekbone, on my forehead, and under my jaw. Look how gorgeous. And I'm gonna warm up my nose here. I like this step. I don't know if I need it, but I like it. I like the look of it. But if you feel like you kinda wanna slim out your nose a little bit, you added that highlight here. I'm gonna take, it's actually my shadow blending brush, but I like it for my nose contouring. I'm just gonna take a little bit, and then when I go like this, you see where that shadow is? That's where I'm gonna put it. I'm not gonna stick it up here because I tried to brighten that up with concealer. We're gonna slim out the nose. If you like this step, go for it. But you don't have to do it. I like to kind of meet it up to my brow. Yep. See, did you see, seriously, if you're watching the replay, rewind and then go back to this look with all that brightness in our face. So now I'm going to take our pressed blusher in Sweet. And I'm going to use our Powder Puff brush right here. This stuff goes a long way. So you can make a funny face, or you can kind of smile and see where that cheekbone is. And if you add a little too much, I always tend to add too much, but I buff it back out. So you're gonna see what I'm gonna do. But I do like a pretty pink cheek. especially under certain lighting. Adding contour to the face will help you not look washed out. Okay, see, look how pretty that is. Really pretty. Oh, so pretty. So now what I do, because I had a little too much blush on one side, I'm going to take the fluffiest brush I have. This is just a Bare Minerals brush. I'm gonna buff that all out. Get rid of those harsh lines. Okay, pretty, huh? Yes. All right, so that is our face. I'm also going to add, I'm just gonna clean my brush off here that I used for that bronzer on my nose. I have this little spongy thing. It was from Amazon, like $6. I'm gonna clean off my brush real quick, make sure there's no pigment on there from that bronzer. And I'm gonna take our Touch a la Mode Luminizer in Benevolent. And this, I'm just gonna add a little bit of shimmer and shine right here. It's not a color, but it's gonna add and just attract that light on those cheekbones. Okay, I'm gonna go down the center of my nose where I had that concealer. There we go. That's my face. That's what we're working with today. I'm gonna put all this face stuff back. And now I'm going to go into brows because they're important. And you guys can see that I have bald spots and unevenness, and that's from overplucking over the years. So we gotta fix those up because brows are super important. And I never realized it until I started doing all this. They are so important. They make the look. They're just necessary. So I'm gonna use our Brow Obsession palette here. Excuse me. And I'm going to use both of these colors right here. One and two. You have a lighter shade and a darker shade. The darker shade I use to kind of underline and over to the center of my brow. And then the lighter shade I use to kind of make it a little more natural in the front. So let's just go for it. We're going to go for it. I literally just like tap into that shade and I tap it off again. Like you need barely any. And I've had this for probably about 6 months. Can you see how long that's gonna last me? Can you see? Because I just tap. It's gonna last me forever. So I like to go under my brow. I use the natural shape. I'm using that darker shade here. Okay. I go over top. I'm gonna fill in that tail. Okay. Now I don't love to put the darker shade up here, but do you see I have that spot? Do you see? And because my roots are darker, I like to put a little filler right there. That is a spot that I plucked that I shouldn't have. That I shouldn't have. And believe me, this was not recent, a recent occurrence. What they tell you in the early 2000s that thin brows are the way to go, they didn't tell you they wouldn't grow back in some spots for some people. So now I take this lighter shade. You're gonna see what I do. I'm gonna take that lighter shade and I'm actually gonna start at that bottom line and start fanning that all in, like marrying those two colors together. So super simple. So I'm gonna use that number one color. Again, just tap. And I'm gonna work it up. And I go in the direction that the brows grow. So in the front, they grow up. And they start working their way this way, right? You guys can see this is a powder. So I'm going to show you the magic of the wax here. Try Check that out. Ah, I love brows. I never even touched them, to be honest, except for plucking them like crazy. And now I'm gonna take that wax, okay? Take that wax and just tap it in. And because this is a powder, I want to seal it in so it's not gonna go anywhere all day, and I promise you it won't. So I'm just going to brush that wax in. Super easy, and this will keep that powder there all day for you. Now, do you see the difference? Do you see how kind of like sassy this eye looks versus this one? And I haven't even done my eye makeup yet. So it's pretty crazy, right? All right, so now I'm gonna do my other eye. I'm gonna do the same thing. And guys, my brows are definitely, I don't even know. They're not even sisters. They're just like not even. But I like to, I personally like to go the way my muscle kind of works. So the natural brow. Like I've said, if you want a desired shape that you might not have, we have stencils on my site which give you amazing, amazing results. So again, I'm going over the top, midway, okay. I don't have to do as much work on this side, on the other side, because I don't have those bald spots over there. Okay. So I'm gonna go into that lighter shade there. And like I did before, I'm gonna meet that dark line there and start fanning it up with the lighter shade to get rid of that harsh line. I do just little strokes, like doop, doop, doop. Yep. Okay. Yeah, I think it looks pretty good. Now I'm going to take that wax again and start fanning that in. Okay. And then you also have these really cool highlight colors. So if you need to clean anything up, you can go in with that, go in with the flat side of my artist brush. And just touch it up a little. Yeah, it looks better. Mm-hmm. Yep. And then I like to just lighten the front up just a little bit. So I take any kind of spoolie that you have. They come on a lot of brushes. This is our brow liner brush, and so it comes with a spoolie, and I love it. I love our brow liners. If that's more your bag and you like to use those versus a palette, go for it. We have amazing ones. They're my favorite, but I am waiting for my medium to get here. I use the medium shade even though my hair is blonde because I have dark roots. So you always want to make sure you match your roots. And brows are a little crazy until you get your makeup on. But I'm telling you, they are key. They will make a huge difference in your makeup. All right, guys, so that is done. Now we're gonna go into our eyes. Our eyes, and people love this look, so I wanna show you. So the colors I'm gonna use, as I drop one, hold on. Didn't crack. Good. Yay. All right, so I'm going to use our pressed pigment shadow pigments. So they come in little singles like this, and you can actually create your own palette. And they're magnetic. It's dirty, sorry. They're magnetic, so you can pop them in and out. Stick something through the hole, you can pop them in. So I wanna show you what I'm gonna be using, and I'm gonna show you the whole palette together. So, Transition color. So the transition color is gonna be up closer to my brow, all over my lid. That's where that color that's gonna pop out when my eyes are open. That is Antsy. It's a really pretty shimmery color. And we're doing more of like a neutral eye today. Okay, and then we're gonna use Nimble for in the crease, the outer crease, I should say. Really pretty chocolatey, milk chocolatey color. I love it. And then we are going to smoke it out with Fervent. Check out that gorgeous shade. It's so beautiful. And then for highlight, under my brow, in the corners of my nose, in my eye, and underneath, I'm going to use Optimistic. Can you see that? It's a really pretty champagne shimmery color. There we go. Can you kind of see that? So pretty. You see how I like grab the light? That's what it's gonna do for you. So guys, popping these all in here. Check out my palette. Check out how beautiful that's gonna be. So we have highlight, we have our transition color, outer crease color, smoke it out, and then highlight. It's gonna be gorgeous. It's gorgeous. So guys, I just take a fluffy brush, right? And I'm gonna go into this color right here. Going to be my transition color, which is why I'm using a fluffy brush, because I kind of just want it all over, okay? And up onto the brow bone, a little higher than normal. And when I do this, you're going to see that I'm going to place these colors, and there might be some lines, harsh lines, but then we're going to blend it out. And I like to bring my shadow up instead of out. Hi, Millie, thanks for hopping on. We're gonna bring it up instead of out because I wanna draw my eye up. If I used to bring it out like this, and that just brings your eye down. So, work that back and forth to our transition color. So when our eyes are open, this color is what's gonna pop out, okay? What I do on the right, gotta do on the left. And we aren't gonna really use any liner today. So it's gonna be a little softer. Yes, a little softer. Thanks for the love, guys. I realized I was using the wrong color on this eye. Oh, goodness. That's what I get. Okay. Back and forth, yes. All right, guys. So now we're gonna go into Nimble right here. And that's gonna be our outer crease color, okay? So I'm gonna use my crease brush, but I am gonna work it up a little bit. You're gonna see what I'm gonna do. So, cleaning off my brush here and my little sponge. I'm just gonna tap that in here. I'm gonna get all sides. Okay. I'm gonna work this back and forth. I'm using, going into my outer crease here. I'm bringing it up slightly above my brow bone, but not as much as I did with that Antsy color. See, I just darkened it up just a little bit. So pretty. Mm-hmm. I love this color. It's one of my favorites. Outer crease, warming it up. Always keeping it up. So that your eye is drawn up, not out. I bring it down to my lid as well, at like an angle, just to make it look all cohesive and all that good stuff. Okay, Now we're gonna go into Fervent and smoke it out. Clean off my brush. Okay. I'm literally tapping it into that Fervent. Not much, guys. You just need to tap with these. Don't do any more. Especially that eye primer, guys. That will go on and it will stay. So I'm literally gonna put this into my crease. I'm not gonna raise it up. I just want it to smoke it out. This really pretty grapey color. See, I'm kind of pressing it a little bit more. This Fervent color has my heart, I'm telling you. Woohoo, check that out. I think we look pretty even here. Yeah. All right, guys. Now we are going to go into the optimistic color right here. And that's going to be kind of our highlight. We're going to brighten up those eyes. Put it on my lid here. And then we're going to go under the brow. Corner of the nose. Under the eye. This is all a palette that I made for myself. Oh, you're welcome, Kathy. Thanks for wanting it again. I know. I always love to doll myself up. It makes me feel good. Bring it into my eye here. And I'm gonna add, I'm not gonna use liner today. And I don't love eyeliner under my eyes. So I'm gonna use my crease brush one more time. And I'm gonna go into Nimble right here. And I'm just gonna blend that into that optimistic under my eye. You're gonna see how cohesive this looks. I meet it up into that, those crease colors. Look how it warms it up, softens it. Yeah. Yep. I meet it up there, still bringing it up. Look how much that softened that up. I always blend it into those other shades. Those are our colors, guys. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna take that same blending brush here, shader brush, I guess, and we're just gonna do little semicircles, okay? And I'm gonna keep bringing it up. I'm not gonna bring it out. Guys, you can always do a smoky eye even if you have deep set eyes like I do. My eyes are open, not much of my lid shows. That is why I brighten up my lid with a lighter color. That's your key, that's your trick. So you see those harsh lines are going away. A little bit more optimistic under the brow here. Yep, there you go. It's beautiful, guys. It's beautiful. Now we're gonna go into our mascara and then we're gonna do a fun lip that I found that I love. So trick, hold your mirror down like your eyes are almost closed. I go to the root and work it up. If you find that your lashes don't curl or they don't hold a curl, it's probably because your tips of your lashes are heavier than the root of your lashes. Oh, just poked myself in the eye. So start at the root, wiggle it, and work it up. You're gonna see it's actually gonna look like I have liner on, and I don't. Because when you wiggle it at the root, it gives that appearance. So I make sure I have more on my root and then fan it up. you go. Check that difference out. If you get any on your face, on your skin, just let it dry. Don't freak out. Let it dry, and then you can take a spoolie like we did with my brows or anything, and you can just flake it off. Okay, so just let it dry. You don't have to ruin your entire makeup look. See that too many times. It will just flake off. Guys, this is the Epic Mascara. This is the one step. It's like I need to focus or something when I put mascara on. I'm like, I can't talk. Guys, I'm so excited for this lip I'm gonna do. I'm so excited. People loved it on my VIP page. So I figured I'd bring it here too. Okay, I'm gonna go in with another coat, but first I'm gonna do my lips because I want that coat to dry. So guys, we're gonna do my lips today, and what we're gonna be using, it's pretty freaking simple, is we're going to use our smudge-proof, kiss-proof, waterproof, water-resistant lip liners, and we're gonna use it in Pompous. It's a really pretty grape color, kind of to go with that fervent, and then we're gonna smooth it out with our lip bonbon here. So, we're gonna do it. So we're gonna line our lips first. Always crisscross at your Cupid's bow. It's an easier way to do it. Any lip product. We're gonna do kind of an ombre lip here. And guys, this lip pencil is smudge proof, kiss proof, waterproof. So as you wear it all day, it will not move. It will not budge. And it's soft, it's not drying. And I kind of hold my pencil flatter so I get more of a fanned out effect instead of a strict line. Okay. I like to thicken that line up a little bit. Okay. Now the magic happens. We're gonna take our vanilla milkshake lip bonbon. Okay. It's just clear. It's pretty awesome. So when it touches your skin, it literally almost like melts. So it gets super soft, but it's not goopy. So super hydrating, so I just work that on. You see that happening? That color is starting to kind of blend out. I'm gonna use a tool that is free for all of you. I'm gonna use my little finger here, my ring finger, gonna blend it out. Out. Oh, Kath. Oh my gosh. Girl, I have super dry lips. This will not crease in your lips. I can't wear lip stains because it all settles in the inner creases of my lips. Super dry. This will be amazing. These have oils in them. Sorry, got stuff on it. Oils in them. Super moisturizing. And also, they don't have... There's something in ChapStick, and I really should look it up because I keep saying this. There's something in like ChapStick in general that has an addictive property, so it makes your lips crave more. Like, you know, we crave chocolate. And this doesn't have it. It's all natural, and you will love this. And the lip liners are so soft. I love this lip, so hope that helps. You know I love a lip look when I just keep going. You see how smooth these glide on? So gorgeous. I love it. So there's our gorgeous pink lip that will last all day. Not drying. I need to clean this off. It's worth it. It's worth it. All right, guys, close that up. Now I'm going to do a second coat of the Epic Mascara because I love a little second coat. I just do. You don't have to. You can stop at this step, but I have always, I don't care if I use CoverGirl Mascara or Epic, I've always done two coats. Since I started putting on makeup as a kid, I've always used two coats. So that's just, I got to do it. And then we'll be done here shortly. That is my fun look for the day. Love how it matches my shirt because I'm such a matchy person. I love it. All right, guys. That is the look for the day. Check it out. So pretty. If you're watching the replay, if you're watching now, let me know if you like it. If you're watching the replay, hashtag replay, let me know what you think. Have a great day, guys. Thank you so much for watching, and I will be talking to you soon.